channel. In this channel, we provide in-depth knowledge of different programming languages, which differentiate you with others. In our series of pointers, as we have discussed in the last class, what is an pointer? Let's recap that class and we will move further. Now, what is pointer? As we have discussed in the last class, if somebody has missed that class, go and check out the video in our channel Hermes Sir Classes. What is pointer? Pointer is a variable which can store the address of another variable. पॉइंटर एक ऐसा वेरिएबल है जो कि एक दूसरे वेरिएबल का एड्रेस स्टोर करता है. वी हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस टू थिंग्स विच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वन इज एम्परसेंड साइन एंड सेकंड वन इज एस्ट्रिक ऑपरेटर. एम्परसेंड साइन मीन्स एड्रेस ऑफ अ वेरिएबल, वेर इज एस्ट्रिक साइन मीन्स वैल्यू एट एड्रेस. दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन द लास्ट क्लास. नाउ लेट्स सी दिस स्मॉल प्रोग्राम. हियर व्हाट वी आर हैविंग, we are having one main function. In main function we are writing int a equal to 10. What is a here? A is a variable of type integer in which 10 is initialized. So as you write int a equal to 10, 4 bytes will be allocated in a RAM with a name a from location number 1000 to 1003. Then int star ptr. What is ptr? Ptr is a pointer to an integer. As we have already discussed in the last class, if any variable is declared with an asterisk sign, it becomes a pointer variable instead of simple variable. So when I write int asterisk ptr, ptr is a pointer to an integer. What does it means? Ki ptr ek aisa pointer hai jiske andar ultimately kya store hoga, ek address. Why? Because in pointers we can only store the addresses, and addresses can be only stored in the pointers. If I am saying ki ptr is a pointer, so ptr will hold some address, aur us address pe kis type ka variable hoga, integer type ka variable hoga. So when I write int star ptr, ptr is a pointer variable. No doubt it's a variable. Variable is a name given to a location in the memory. So as you write int star ptr, 4 bytes will be allocated in a RAM with a name ptr from location number 2000 to 2003. Ptr equal to end of a. End of a means 1000. Here we have already discussed the base address of the variable always stored in a pointer, because pointer is nothing but a variable, but variable can store one value at same point of time. So all the four values from 1000 to 1003 cannot be stored. So in pointers, the base address or the starting address of a variable is always stored. So ptr is holding what? The base address of variable a. Now this ptr will start pointing to location number 1000. Now when I write printf percentage ia, what I will get? I will get 10 here. No doubt it's a simple printf statement or printf function call. We are getting 10 here. Now when I write printf percentage u ptr, ptr is holding what? Ptr is holding 1000. We will get 1000. Printf percentage u end of a. End of a means address of a. Address of a is what? Again we are getting 1000. Printf percentage u end of ptr. End of ptr means address of ptr. Address of ptr is what? The 2000. Then printf percentage I value at ptr. Ptr mein kya hai? 1000. Means this value at ptr will convert into value at 1000. Now simple English, value at 1000. 1000 pe kaun si value hai? Wo kaun si value hai? That is 10. So if you want to access any value from any variable using pointer, so we can use value at address operator. Then we write printf percentage I value at a. Here we will get an error, l value required. L value required means left hand side ki value required hai. Now why the compiler gives this error? Now see here, asterisk sign, when we use this asterisk sign with a pointer variable, it start working as a value at address operator or indirection operator. But if it is used with a simple variable, what is a here? A is a simple variable. If it is used with a simple variable, it start working as a multiplication operator. Multiplication operator is a binary operator. Multiplication operator is a binary operator. Binary operator मतलब two operands. Binary operator means two operands. What are operands? Operands are the things on which operator performs the operation. For example, if I write a plus b, here plus is what? Plus is an operator, whereas a and b are operand. Fine. So when I write a value at a, now here this asterisk sign is start working as a multiplication operator. Multiplication operator is a binary operator. Binary operator means two operands, as we have already discussed. We cannot change the number of operand of an operator at any cost. If it is a unary operator, it always work with one operand. If it is a binary operator, it always work with two operand. If it's a tertiary operator, it always work with three operand. So this multiplication operator is a binary operator. It needs two operands. So we are only passing how many operands? We are passing only one operand. So it is giving us an error. L value required. This we have already discussed in the last class. Now let's move further. Now let's see some tips regarding pointers. When I write int, first point, int and addresses are pole apart. What does it means? It is looking like an integer. 10 is what? 10 is an integer. 1000 is what? 1000 is a looking like an integer, but they are pole apart. To understand this point, let's take an example. Now, suppose somebody is getting salary of 5000 rupees. Fine, किसी को 5000 salary मिल रही है और किसी का car registration number भी 5000 है और 5000 है. किसी का car का number भी कितना है? 5000 है. और अगर वो बंदे को 500 rupees as a dearness allowance मिलता है, तो इफ आई आस्क दैट पर्सन कि हाउ मच यू गेट एज अ डियरनेस अलाउंस, ही ऑलवेज सेज आई एम गेटिंग 10% ऑफ माय बेसिक सैलरी. ही नेवर सेज आई एम गेटिंग 10% ऑफ माय कार रजिस्ट्रेशन नंबर. इवन बोथ आर 5000, बट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस 5000 इज एन वैल्यू, whereas this 5000 is a symbol. तो इसके कुछ अलग arithmetic operations होंगे, इसके कुछ arithmetic operations अलग होंगे, that we are planning in the future classes, that we will discuss in the future classes, how this int as a value or symbol differentiate with each other. But right now you should understand कि one is an integer and second one is symbol. Second one is address is a symbol. We cannot apply an arithmetic to any symbol. Obviously, we never add or subtract or multiply or divide a car registration number, never, or house number, never. And operator is applied to variable, not to constant or not to expression. This we have already discussed. Okay, this ampersand sign is always used with an variable, not with an constant, and not with expressions. They are always used with a variables. Fine. Next, any variable can be changed by ampersand asterisk, or you can say any variable value can be changed or manipulated using asterisk and ampersand sign. Let's see one example how we can do this. Now here we are having a variable of type integer, int a equal to 10. 4 bytes will be allocated in a RAM with a name a at location number 1000 to 1003, and 10 will be stored. Int star ptr is equal to end of a. Again, what is ptr? Ptr is a pointer to an integer. This ptr holds ptr is equal to end of a. End of a means address of a. Address of a is what? 1000. So this 1000 will be stored at this location. Fine. Then printf percentage ia, what I will get? I will get 10 here. I think no doubt here that we have discussed just 5 minutes before. Then what I write? Printf percentage u value at ptr. Value at ptr is what? Value at ptr is what? Value at ptr is nothing but again 10. Ptr is holding what? Ptr is holding 1000. Value at 1000 is 10. Now this line is very important. What I write? Asterisk ampersand of a equal to 60. Now what is a here? A is a variable. Address of a is what? Address of a is what? 1000. And next line what? Value at 1000 should be 60. So when I write value at 1000, so what we are doing? We are indirectly referring to this location. Value at 1000 should be equal to 60. I can write a equal to 60. I can write value at end of a is again a 60. Both are same. जैसे अपन already last class में भी discuss किए थे ना, suppose ये आपका घर है, आपका नाम क्या है? राम, ठीक है? आपका मकान का नाम क्या होगा? Suppose गुरु कृपा, और आपका मकान नंबर क्या है? Suppose 50. Now if you want to meet Mr. Ram, अगर किसी को राम से मिलना है तो उसके बाद दो ऑप्शन है, या तो उसको घर का नाम पता होना चाहिए या तो घर का एड्रेस पता होना चाहिए. दोनों में से कुछ भी एक पता होगा तो ही कैन मीट राम वेरी इजिली. सेम थिंग इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मैनिपुलेट दिस 10, आइदर यू नो द नेम ऑफ द हाउस और आइदर यू नो द एड्रेस. आई राइट ए इक्वल टू 60, इन विच केस वेन आई नो the name of the house, and when I write value at end of a, it means we are manipulating this location with the help of address and asterisk operator. That is why what we have written here, ki with the help of ampersand and asterisk any variable value can be changed. Fine. Any doubt you can ask me, otherwise we will move further. Now let's come back to the function. What is function? Function is a set of instruction which perform a specific task. We have already discussed in function class what is function, how function works. We are having this fourth lecture on function. We have already 3 lectures. If anybody is interested or missed out that 3 lectures, go and check out on our channel Harbhajan sir classes. Now what is function? Function is a self-contained block of instruction which performs a specific task. We have already discussed, if you want to communicate between two functions, we are using something known as arguments, and these arguments can be passed in two ways. First one is called by value and second one is called by reference. We have already discussed what is called by value. In call by value, the copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Call by value में क्या होता है? Actual argument की एक copy बनती है और वो किस में pass हो जाती है? Formal arguments. What are arguments? Anything between the parentheses of the function. Anything between the parentheses of the functions are known as arguments. So there are two types of arguments. First one is actual argument and second one is formal arguments. The arguments given in the function call, they swap a comma b is what? It's a function call. The arguments given in the function call, they are known as actual arguments, and the arguments given in the function definition, they are known as formal arguments. These arguments can be this function call can be called using call by value or call by reference. Call by value and call by reference का मतलब क्या है? ये arguments को अपन दो तरीके से function में भेज सकते हैं, या तो by value और second one is by reference. By value we have already discussed in the previous class. Today we are going to discuss what is call by address. Let's take an example of call by value. In call by value, the copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. functions. Let's check one example. Here we are having one function called swap. What is void swap int comma int? This is a function prototype. What is function prototype? It's a declaration which defines the return type and the argument of the function. So what we are writing is swap is a user defined function. Why it's a user defined function? Because the body of this function is defined by the user. Void swap int comma int. Swap is a user defined function which returns nothing, but it receives two integer values. This is an example of bivalue. In bivalue, what happens? The copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Here in main, we are having int a comma b, a equal to 10, b equal to 20. 44 bytes will be allocated at two different locations with a name a and b. One is initialized with 10 and second one is initialized with 20. Any doubt here? I think no doubt here. Then printf %i a comma b, what I will get? I will get 10 and 20. Simple program. Now here what we are doing, we are making a function call to the swap function and we are passing two values by which method? Bivalue method. In bivalue, the copy of actual argument, here a and b are what? A and b are actual arguments. The copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. So the copy of here a, the copy of a will be passed to x and the copy of b will be passed to y. Copy means, if I write a equal to 10, then b equal to a, the copy of a is passed to b. अब a की वैल्यू b में चलेगी तो a खाली नहीं हो गया, a के अंदर भी 10 रहेगा और b के अंदर भी क्या 10 हो जाएगा. तो copy of a will be passed in b, just like a photocopy ना. If you do one photocopy, it doesn't means कि original paper will be wipe out. Original के अंदर भी वो data रहेगा और duplicate copy में भी वही रहेगा, copy में भी. Fine. Now the copy of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Here a is what? A is a actual argument, b is a argument, a is having 10, b is having 10. 10 will be passed in x, here int x, 10 will be stored x and y ke andar kya aajayega? 20. Now listen it carefully. What we are seeing here, we are having a swap int x comma y. X and y are two variables. These are known as formal arguments. And we have already discussed the number, order and type of the actual argument and the formal argument should always be same. The number, order and type of the actual argument and formal argument should always be same. Means if we are passing two arguments, we have to receive in two arguments. If we are passing three arguments, we have to receive in three arguments. If we are passing integer, we have to receive in integer. If we are passing float, we have to receive in float. If we are passing order integer float, we have to receive in integer float. If we are passing float integer, we have to receive in float integer. But here in this example, we are having both the values in integer, so we are writing int x comma int y. Copy of a will be passed in x and the copy of b will be passed in y. So here x will be initialized with a value 10 and 20 will be initialized, y will be initialized with 20. Then printf %x, y 10 and 20. Then with the help of third variable, we are swapping the value. Swapping the value matlab x ki value y mein aur y ki value x mein. So c is equal to x, to c mein kya chale aega? 10. X is equal to y. X is equal to y matlab this 20 will be transfer to 10 and this 10 will be vanish. Then y equal to c, this 10 will be passed to here, this 20 will be replaced with 10. Now when I write printf %i x comma y, to x mein kitni value chale jayegi 20 aur y mein kitni value jayegi 10. As it encounter the closing brace, the return goes back to the calling function from where the function call is made. Now in this main function, what we are saying, we are having printf %i a comma b. Again, what we are getting? We are getting 10 and 20. What does it mean? This x and y is local to this swap function. the value manipulated in x and y is not reflected in a and b. Why? A and b is local to the main function, or you can say this a and b belongs to the main function and this int x and y belongs to the swap function. Again, take an example of photocopy. आप किसी भी पेपर का एक फोटोकॉपी कीजिए और फोटोकॉपी पे अगर आप साइन करोगे तो ओरिजिनल में ऑटोमेटिक साइन नहीं हो जाएगा ना, बिकॉज फोटोकॉपी इज हैविंग अ डिफरेंट आइडेंटिटी एंड ओरिजिनल कॉपी इज हैविंग डिफरेंट आइडेंटिटी. सेम थिंग, ए एंड बी आर वेरिएबल्स बिलोंगिंग टू द मेन फंक्शन, वेयर एज एक्स एंड वाई आर द फंक्शन वेरिएबल बिलोंगिंग टू द स्वैप फंक्शन. मीन्स जो वैल्यू एक्स एंड वाई में चेंज होगी इट विल नॉट बी रिफ्लेक्टेड इन A and B. Why? Because the copy of A is passed in B. Now, what are the uses of these functions? That we will see when we will go for some project. First, you learn the tools. Once you are comfortable with tools, ki how we can task jab aayega project ke andar aapko ye karna hai. Kaise karna hai? तब आपके पास सारे टूल्स होने चाहिए. यू शुड नो पॉइंटर्स, यू शुड नो फंक्शन, यू शुड नो एरेज, यू शुड नो स्ट्रिंग, यू शुड नो फाइल हैंडलिंग. देन ओनली यू विल बी एबल टू राइट अ प्रोजेक्ट और राइट अ प्रोग्राम और डेवलप अ सॉफ्टवेयर. अंटिल और अनलेस यू आर नॉट कंफर्टेबल विथ लैंग्वेज, हाउ यू विल डेवलप अ सॉफ्टवेयर? तो फर्स्ट सारे टूल्स से आप ओके हो जाइए. वंस यू आर कंफर्टेबल विथ ऑल द टूल्स हैविंग एनी लैंग्वेज, देन वी कैन गो फॉर अ प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, now any doubt in this call by value that we have already discussed in previous classes. Next is call by reference. Now what happens in call by reference? In call by reference, the address of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. Now pointers comes into scene. Why? Because we are talking about the addresses. We have already discussed ki if we talk about addresses, pointers will comes into scene, and if we talk about pointers, addresses will comes into scene. Why? Because in pointers we can only store the addresses, and addresses can be only stored in the pointers. Now what swap int asterisk comma int asterisk, what does it means? Again, it's a prototype of the function, the same program we are making using call by reference. What swap int asterisk comma int asterisk, what does it means? कि स्वैप इज अ यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शन विच विल रिटर्न नथिंग बट इट विल रिसीव टू एड्रेसेस ऑफ टाइप इंटीजर. इफ इट विल रिसीव टू एड्रेसेस तो ऑब्वियसली यू हैव टू रिसीव इन पॉइंटर्स. नाउ हियर इंट ए कॉमा बी, टू वेरिएबल्स विल बी डिफाइंड एट लोकेशन नंबर 1000 एंड 2000. वैल्यू विल बी इनिशियलाइज 10 एंड 20. प्रिंट एफ परसेंटेज आई परसेंटेज आई ए कॉमा बी, आउटपुट विल बी 10 and 20. Up to here, any doubt? No doubt. Now this is call by reference. Swap ampersand of A and ampersand of B. What does it mean? In call by reference, the address of actual argument is passed to the formal argument. The address of A is what? 1000. 1000 will be passed, and the address of B is what? 2000. This 2000 will be passed, right? Any doubt? Now if we are passing the addresses, no doubt we have to receive in what? We have to receive in something known as pointers. So here we are having two pointers, int asterisk x, int asterisk y. Again, 44 bytes will be allocated in a RAM at a particular location. X will hold the 1000. 1000 is what? 1000 is an address of what? Address of A. Address of A is what? 1000. The 1000 is passed, AND of A, AND of A will be stored at X, and AND of B means 2000 will be stored at Y. What is X and Y? X and Y are pointers. Pointers of type integer. Why we have to write integer? Because A and B are what? Integer. Agar aapko integer type ka address store karna hai, तो इंटीजर टाइप का पॉइंटर लेना है. अगर फ्लोट टाइप का एड्रेस स्टोर करना है तो फ्लोट टाइप का पॉइंटर लेना है. तो एड्रेस ऑफ ए एंड एड्रेस ऑफ बी इज पास्ड विच इज रिसीव्ड इन एक्स एंड वाई. एक्स एंड वाई आर द पॉइंटर्स. देन अगेन थर्ड वेरिएबल इंट सी, प्रिंट एफ परसेंटेज आई वैल्यू एट एक्स एंड वैल्यू एट वाई. value at x matlab value at 1000, value at 1000 is what? 10. I will get 10 here. Value at y means value at 2000, value at 2000 is what? 20. So I will get 20 here. So 10 and 20 will be displayed. Then with the help of variable c, we are swapping the value. C is equal to value at x. Value at x is what? 10. 10 will be initialized to c. Then value at x is equal to value at y. Now concentrate on this statement. Value at x matlab value at 1000 should be equal to value at 2000. Means 2000 पे जो वैल्यू है, 2000 पे कौन सी वैल्यू है? 20. वो कहाँ पे हो जानी चाहिए? 1000 पे चले जानी चाहिए. तो हियर इंस्टेड ऑफ 10 इट विल बी इनिशियलाइज विथ 20. और उसके बाद हम क्या बोल रहे हैं, वैल्यू एट 2000 मीन्स वैल्यू एट वाई शुड बी इक्वल टू सी. सी में कितनी वैल्यू है? 10. दिस 10 विल बी इनिशियलाइज इन बी. फाइन. एज इट एनकाउंटर्स द क्लोजिंग ब्रेस द कंट्रोल गोज बैक टू द मेन फंक्शन प्रिंटएफ परसेंटेज आई ए कॉमा बी. As in the case of call by value, we are getting 10, 20. Here we are going getting 20 and 10. What does it mean? With the help of pointers, ultimately ये चीज़ मान के रखिए, addresses are so powerful. Now imagine a situation कि आप दिल्ली गए हो. दिल्ली में मैं बोलता हूँ मिस्टर राम से मिल के आ जाइएगा. तो पहला क्वेश्चन आपका क्या होगा? सर एड्रेस दे दीजिए. अगर एड्रेस आपके होगा तो आप मिस्टर राम को बहुत आसानी से मिल लोगे. सेम थिंग, स्वैप फंक्शन इज हैविंग द एड्रेसेस ऑफ ए एंड बी. अब एड्रेसेस है तो विद द हेल्प ऑफ एड्रेसेस वी कैन मैनिपुलेट द वैल्यू वेरी इजीली दैट वी हैव डिस्कस जस्ट 10 मिनट्स बिफोर. कि विद द हेल्प ऑफ एस्ट्रिक एम्परसेंड साइन एनी वैल्यू ऑफ अ वेरिएबल कैन बी इजीली मैनिपुलेटेड और चेंज. तो वी आर हैविंग एक्स एंड वाई pointer of type integer in which address of a and b. With the help of these addresses we are manipulating the value of a and b. This is how call by reference works in C language. Go through this. Any doubt you can ask me, otherwise we will move further. Again, printf percentage i percentage i, value x and value y is 20 and 10. So this is what? This is called by reference. What is this? Suppose if I write, let me write here, swap empty parenthesis. Is it called by value or called by reference? It's a simple function call. So this by reference and by addresses, we are talking in the terms of arguments. Function call to simple function call hi hoga. This is also a function call. And suppose if I write this is function call, this is function call, and this is also a function call. All three are function call, but here we are not passing any arguments. Here arguments are passed by value and here arguments are passed by reference. But in general terms, we always say call by value and call by reference. Now one common doubt, are we returning any value from this function? Yes or no? क्या हम कोई value return कर रहे हैं क्या swap function से main function में? Answer is a big no. Why? Because swap is returning what? Returning void. Void means it will return nothing. But with the help of addresses, we are able to manipulate the local variables of the calling function or the main function. Ultimately, agar aapke paas address aa gaya, you can find out the house very easily, na? Here, swap is having the addresses of A and B. If they are having the addresses of A and B, so they can manipulate the value of A and B very easily. By just saying asterisk ampersand of ptr equal to this, or asterisk value at x is equal to 10 and value at y is equal to 20. So this is call by reference. So there are two types in which arguments can be passed, by value or by reference. Any doubt you can ask me. Otherwise, for today it is enough. We have already discussed what is pointers, what is called by value, and what is called by reference. If any doubt, you can ask me. And if you like the content of this channel, please like, share and subscribe as much you can. Thank you very much.